for riser of the week in the tight end spot, who have you got here, mate?
Riser of the week. Another one of your men, Gronkowski. You've found
mate,
you...
I appreciate it.
Well, you had an unreal week, but you've finally found yourself your tight end one, I reckon, with the Gronk, because he genuinely looks good, and he's projected 12 on fantasy this week, which is like top five tight ends.
For a tight end.
Top five tight ends. So maybe he's finally clicking into that offense.
Yeah, well, he was my tight end 13 going into it. So I wasn't too happy to be playing him, but it was because Jared Cook had the bye, who was also my tight end 12. So it's pretty dire straits there. Tried my hardest to get Ertz. So thank whoever is control of the world for rejecting that trade. But yeah, pretty happy with the Gronk. A few guys have had a crack at him this season. I think he got drafted fairly early. But I think I'm finally going to reap the rewards of what he was promising. But yeah, very happy to have Gronk on my side, looking good, looking, even with all the receivers back, he still looks like he's going to be one of Brady's favorite targets, especially in the end zone. And playing on a good team, an end zone target is what we like to see, a bit like Jonnu Smith. But yeah, it'll be interesting to see how high he can go on my rankings, because there are quite a few good tight ends. But my riser of the week is my former man, Austin Hooper. I think he's been the riser of the week 3 weeks in a row. But
not ideal.
Every week, he just keeps getting stronger. He had 10.2 against the Steelers, following a 10.7 against the Colts. We're talking about two of the best defenses in the league right there. 6+ targets for 3 weeks in a row now. And now he's got Cincinnati, Las Vegas, and Houston, which are all very favorable pass defenses. So yeah, very excited to see what Hooper can do in the next month. If he can add a few touchdowns to the board, he's going to skyrocket in value. Could legit become one of the top five, given his target rate. Obviously, Baker's not the greatest quarterback to have. He loves his, 50% completions. We see Odell getting bloody 11 targets, four receptions, stuff like that. But I like Austin Hooper a lot. Faller of the week, who have you? Oh, have you got another riser? Sorry.
Trey Burton. We just talked about him before at the Colts, but I think he's kind of announcing himself as the number one tight end there. I think Jack Doyle might be injured still. Not 100% sure about that, but he's Mo'Ali Cox has fallen off the face of the earth, and Burton looks quite good. I was genuinely going to stream him this week, but I just chose Jimmy Graham over him, which was all right because he scored like 9. But yeah,
I might pick up Jimmy Graham, but don't know if I rate him over.
He looks quite good. He got 8 targets, I think.
Yeah, he gets peppered. It's just whether the Bears can score enough points to make him a great asset to the side. I just don't know if I rate him over Cook or Gronkowski, but we'll see how the rankings turn out this week.
Indeed.
Mo'Ali Cox has been injured the last 2 weeks. That's where he's gone. But even before then, he wasn't getting many targets. He was just like an end zone specialist. So, I think Trey Burton, I think he's shown in the past as well. He's got what it takes to be a top level tight end. So we'll see what he can produce in the next few rounds. But I rate that one. Bit of a pod, big fan of it. Faller of the week for me, I only had one riser because stuff the tight ends. But faller of the week for me by an absolute country mile, Mike Gesicki. What are you doing, my friend? He's got. Were you against him?
Yeah. I was stoked.
You were laughing.
I was stoked to say that.
If he got like 20, were you in trouble or no?
No, I won by like 50.
Oh, no worries there, mate. But he had 2 targets out of his team, 7 tight end targets. I don't even know the other bloke's name. Adam Shaheen Shafridi. Adam Shaheen and Durham Smythe or something. They both had touchdowns. So to think his name is Smythe.
Mate, that's
S-M-Y-T-H-E. It can't be Smith.
That's like on Ricky Ponting Cricket 05 when they can't spell the names correctly. So Steve Smith's name is spelled as like Steve Smythe.
No, they were the best. But yeah, I've got Mike Gesicki. two targets out of the team's seven. Both the other tight ends had touchdowns, so they might see a bit more action in the following weeks. But yeah, zero receptions against the Jets. They're a bottom five pass defense. And he's got the bye this week, and then following that, he's got the Rams, the Cardinals, the Chargers, and the Broncos. So if you have Gesicki right now, good luck trying to trade him. But honestly, trade him, because you do not want him in your side. He was my QB 7 coming into the my tight end 7. It sounds way better than TE 7. But yeah. My tight end 7. So yeah, get off the Mike Gesicki bus. Who are your fours?
Yeah, Mike Gesicki as well. And Evan Engram, he's kind of been falling every week, but it's finally at the point where he's just absolutely irrelevant and he's an absolute bust. Like, he's just scored like 4 points every single week. I don't know. I actually don't know what's happened to him. Because
Who gets the Giants yards? who gets the yards, mate? I don't get who gets them. Like, they actually honestly must have 150 team yards every week.
Danny Dimes, like, genuinely struggles to go over 200 yards each week. He normally scrambles for, like, 60 yards and still scores 8 fantasy points.
So, yeah, I don't know. Because, like, Freeman didn't even do that well on the weekend. We've just both said Engram and Slayton had shockers, and they've somehow won. Like, I'm not sure where the missing piece is, but... There's some Giants myth out there who's balling. We just don't know who he is. But yeah, that's it for the player / fantasy section.
It's a miracle. Oh, yeah. What about that one? Nardello. Unbelievable.
Balotelli. Aguero. Crowd cheers. Here's Siddle.